friends, let me ask a question. What is the common properties of these figures? Yes, all of these are in circular shape. In our daily life, we come across many objects which are related to circles, shape in some form or the others. That is why the problem of finding perimeter and areas related to circular figures is of great practical importance. Let's study about this detailly in the chapter 12, area related to circles. Now we are going to see the first topic, perimeter and area of a circle, a review. Recall the distance covered by traveling once around a circle, its perimeter, usually called its circumference. You also know from your earlier classes that circumference of a circle bears a constant ratio with its diameter. This constant ratio is denoted by the Greek letter pi. It is read as pi. In other words, pi is equal to circumference divided by diameter. From this, circumference equal to pi into diameter. So, pi into 2r, because where r is the radius of the circle. So, the circumference will be 2 pi r. However, for practical purpose, we generally take the value of pi as 22 by 7 or 3.14 approximately. Let's see an example. The question is, the radii of two circles are 19 cm and 9 cm respectively. Find the radius of the circle which has circumference equal to the sum of the circumference of the two circles. Let's see the answer. Here, radius R1 of first circle is equal to 19 cm. Then, radius of R2 or second circle equal to 9 cm. Let the radius of third circle be R, then the circumference of first circle is equal to 2 pi R1, that is equal to 2 pi into 19, that will be 38 pi. Then, circumference of second circle, that is equal to 2 pi R2, that will be 2 pi into 9, it will be 18 pi. Then the circumference of third circle is equal to 2 pi R. Given that circumference of third circle equal to circumference of first circle plus circumference of second circle, that will be 2 pi R equal to 38 pi plus 18 pi. So that will be 56 pi. Here, R is equal to 56 pi divided by 2 pi, that will be 28. Therefore, the radius of the circle which has circumference equal to the sum of the circumference of the given two circle is 28 cm. Okay, moving on to the second topic, areas of a sector and segment of a circle. First, we are going to see about circle. Locus of a point which moves in a plane in such a way that its distance from a fixed point always constant. The fixed point is called the center and a constant distance is called the radius of the circle. If R be the radius of the circle, then first one, circumference is equal to 2 pi R or pi D, where D is equal to 2R is the diameter of the circle. Point 2, here area equal to pi R square or pi D square divided by 4. Point 3, area of semicircle is equal to pi R square divided by 2. And the last point, area of a quadrant of a circle, that is equal to pi R square divided by 4. The arc of circle is part of the circumference of the circle. Now we are going to see a subtopic, area enclosed between two concentric circles. See that if capital R and small r are two radii of concentric circles, then area enclosed between two concentric circles, that is equal to pi R square minus pi R square, that is equal to pi into R square minus R square, that will be pi into R plus R into R minus R. See the point 1. If two circles touch internally, then the difference of their radii is equal to the distance between their centers. Number 2. If two circles touch externally, then the sum of their radii is equal to the distance between their centers. Number 3. Distance moved by a rotating wheel in one revolution is equal to the circumference of the circle. Number 4. The number of revolutions completed by rotating wheel in 1 minute, that will be distance moved in 1 minute circumference. Now we go into another subtopic, sector of a circle. The circular region enclosed by 2 radii and the corresponding arc of a circle is called the sector of a circle. See this figure. Here OAPB is called the minor sector and OAQB is called the major sector. Let's see some points. Number 1. Sum of the arcs of a major and minor sector of a circle is equal to circumference of the circle. Number 2. The sum of the areas of major and minor sector of a circle is equal to the area of the circle. Now we are going to see another topic, angle of the sector. The angle sustained by the corresponding arc of the sector at the center of the circle is called the angle of the sector. Let's see some points. Number 1. Area of a sector of angle theta, theta divided by 360 into pi r square, or 1 by 2 into length of arc into radius, that will be 1 by 2 LR. Another point, length of an arc of angle theta, that will be theta divided by 360 into 2 pi R. Let's see some short topics. Segment of a circle. The circular region enclosed between a chord and the corresponding arc is called the segment of a circle. Another one, minor segment. If the boundary of a segment is a minor arc of a circle, then the corresponding segment is called a minor segment. Next, major segment. A segment corresponding a major arc of a circle is called as major segment. Friends, see this figure. Here, APB is called minor segment and AQB is called the major segment. See the next figure. The area of segment is the area of the corresponding sector minus the area of the corresponding triangle. Let's see some important formula related to this figure. Number 1. Area of segment APB equal to area of sector OAPB minus area of triangle OAB. That will be theta by 360 into pi r square minus 1 by 2 r square sine theta. Another one. Angle described by minute hand in 60 minutes, that will be 360. Then, angle described by minute hand in 1 minute, that will be 360 degree divided by 60, that will be 6 degree. Next, angle described by hour and in 12 hours, that will be 360 degree. Then, angle described by hour and in 1 hour is equal to 360 degree divided by 12, that will be 30 degree. Then, angle described by hour and in 1 minute, that will be 360 into 2 all divided by 60, that will be 12 degree. Let's see an important example under this concept. The question is, find the area of a sector of a circle with radius 6 cm if angle of the sector is 60 degree. Let's see the solution. See this figure. Let OACB be a sector of the circle making 60 degree angle at center O of the circle. Area of sector of angle theta equal to theta divided by 360 into pi r square. Then area of sector OACB equal to 60 degree divided by 360 into 22 by 7 into 6 square. That will be 1 by 6. Into 22 by 7 into 6 into 6. So that will be 132 divided by 7 centimeter square. Therefore, the area of the sector of the circle making 60 degree at the center of the circle is 132 divided by 7 centimeter square. Now we are going to see the major topic, areas of combinations of a plane figures. A collection of points that are on a plane is known as a plane figure. Example, Calculate the area of the figure which has a non-standard form is involving basic geometric figure such as circles, squares, triangle, rectangle, etc. See this figure. Here the area of the figure equal to area of the rectangle plus 2 into area of semicircles. See another figure. Here the area of the recurved region equal to 3 by 4 into pi r1 square minus pi r2 square. Now we are going to see another figure. See this. Here the area of the recurved region equal to pi r square minus a square. Let's see an example. Find the area of the shaded region in this figure. If PQ equal to 24 cm, PR equal to 7 cm and O is the center of the circle. See the solution. It can be observed that RQ is the diameter of the circle. Therefore, angle RPQ will be 90 degree. By applying Pythagoras theorem in triangle PQR, RP square plus PQ square equal to RQ square. That will be 7 square plus 24 square equal to RQ square. After the calculation, we get RQ equal to root of 625. That will be 25. Then the radius of the circle R equal to RQ divided by 2 equal to 25 divided by 2. Since RQ is the diameter of the circle, it divides the circle into two equal parts. Now, area of semicircle RPQOR, that will be half pi r square. That will be 1 by 2 pi into 25 divided by 2 all square. That will be 1 by 2 into 22 by 7 into 625 divided by 4. So, after the calculation, we get 6875 divided by 28 centimeter square. Then, area of triangle PQR equal to half into PQ into PR. Put the values, half into 24 into 7, that will be 84 centimeter square. So, area of shaded region equal to area of semicircle RPQOR minus area of triangle PQR. This will be 6875 divided by 28 minus 84. Then it will be 6875 minus 2352 divided by 28. So that will be 4523 divided by 28 centimeter square. Okay friends, this is the end of the chapter. I think all of you well studied about this chapter and well studied about the concept of circles. We will meet again with another chapter. Till that, goodbye.